But it is a little bit,
Good morning and welcome back to my channel. It is Saturday today, which means it is show day tomorrow. We're all settled in to the Airbnb. It is obviously quite early, you've just seen. Check-ins have just been done and I'm now wrapped up because I'm so cold, so cold. I'm waiting basically to head off and get a coffee because that's the first thing that we need to do. Apart from that, plan of action today is rest, feet up, get my meals in. We're ever so slightly tapering back carbohydrates today because we've been filling up for the last kind of 4 or 5 days, so there's no need to push a ton of food in. And then I will be checking in at around 2 o'clock with Vicky, just because I'm due on stage 2 o'clock tomorrow, so it makes sense to assess the look at that point. But apart from that, we have tanning a little bit later and then athlete registration, which is all very exciting. So literally the most boring shop ever, ran out of eggs. Needing an avocado, and I'll be needing more of these for tomorrow. So fast forward a few hours, I have done my final hair wash and we are just, yeah, as I was saying, Louis will be training today, and then I am gonna do a little bit of posing at the leisure center. Got a tiny bit of food to get for the rest of today's meals, but we are all ready, and as you can see, it's a lot of bags for us to leave, even just for 2 hours. Bags, all the meal prep in here, and scales, of course. So we've just gotten to the leisure center. Louis is just starting his session upstairs. I am just about to eat the meal. I have chicken, avocado, blueberries, and a rice cake. So just normal meals today. We haven't really changed anything. And then I'll just be helping Louis with his session, and by the time he's pretty much finished training, it'll be time for my first day of tan, shortly followed by registration, and then a little bit of a check-in with Vicky. So I'm gonna get this. Probably the next time you see me, I will be in my first day of tan, and things will feel very real, because right now they don't feel that real yet. Just because I've been so chilled out, I haven't really been doing anything. Good morning, it is show day. Vicky has just arrived. We're gonna go through an in-person check-in. As you can see, the tan got quite a lot darker. I did have a really good sleep last night as well, so I'm very pleased about that. So I'm just gonna chuck my bikini on and see what's going on.
She's very dry on the midsection. And back.
So chest high when you do that as well.
So I've just had my makeup done by the lovely Danielle Spencer. She is amazing. She's done my face before. And I absolutely love it. So there is no more pale, nasty looking Ali. This is the show day Ali. So now we're just heading back to the Airbnb to have another meal, and then we'll be going back for more tan just a little bit later. Oh baby, you wanna dance.
There we go. Stay tall. Good go.
271. If you notice, you went far back to the diagonal. What, do you want to join these ladies too? Towards the back of the stage.
It's now on Monday. Obviously I competed yesterday. We've just finished training actually because I wanted to come in and train. Had a really nice session in there actually. The kit's pretty good. And like I said before, it's just nice to get moving and actually train with Louis for the first time in I don't even know how long.
A long time.
A very long time. So that was nice. Just nice to spend a bit of time together without me having to, you know, be feeling hungry and tired. So yesterday I didn't really get much footage on my camera, but I did get some footage on phones and things like that, so hopefully I would have been able to pop that into this video. I entered three classes. I placed in two of them, third place and then another third place. I'm a little bit disappointed about my placing, however I'm genuinely very happy about how I looked. It's the best I've looked ever. With that in mind, I can't really be too negative. The plan from here is we are 23 days away from the UKDFBA finals. Put this show kind of behind us. Obviously, when I can look at comparison pictures and that kind of thing, it'll be really interesting to see what the judges say in terms of what my feedback is. But we've got our finals to do, and I can't let one show and potentially an outcome I wasn't hoping for kind of ruin this next 23 days. So I've actually been given a bit of a day off plan today regarding food. So I'll be having what I fancy. Don't really fancy that much, to be honest, but now that I've trained, I do have a little bit of an appetite, which is nice. I'm not planning on going crazy, but it will be nice to not be tracking or weighing out food all day. The up here, not much else to say. Hopefully I'll be able to put some pictures in from yesterday, but as always for me, I love being on stage, and I don't think a placing can really take that away from me, just because I enjoy it that much. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and hopefully the finals will bring some sort of improvement on the fourth place at the finals, which was what I got in 2019. So the goal is obviously to place higher than fourth. YouTube, I just wanted to do a little bit of a sit down talk. It is now the 24th of September, so I'm what, 5 days post show and 3 weeks out from UKDFBA finals. It's been a really not interesting, I haven't felt great for the last 5 days, I can't lie. I've had many a phone call to Louis, I've had discussions with my mum, I've had discussions with Vicky, and I generally just haven't been feeling particularly great after the weekend. And I always try and be transparent. I'm not going to sit here and tell you that I feel great if I don't. Like, the last 5 days I just haven't felt great at all. That doesn't mean that I haven't adhered to my plan 100%. It doesn't mean that I've half-assed my sessions. And you know, he just reminded me of the fact that
you know, we can't win all the time. And I think this is something that I have to really remember. I had a very successful first season, and I had a lot of highs and not many lows at all. And then coming into this season, my body was very different at the start of this prep, hormonally as well, with being on different birth control and just general body fat patterning. It's been a very different prep. Not really the prep I expected, but the prep that Vicky told me it would have to be, based on what I did in my off season, which I live to regret every day. But there we go. Louis really kind of reminded me that I am doing everything in my power to bring the best look. So without waffling on too much about that, I just wanted to kind of update you guys on where things are at right now. So we are 3 weeks out from the UKDFBA finals, which I'm pretty sure is going to be my last competition of the season. So cardio is back in. Cardio is higher than it has been for the majority of prep now. We are pushing. My legs are not as lean as they should be, in my opinion as well. I've been a lot leaner than I am right now. So I'm, whether this is a good thing or a bad thing, I'm constantly comparing to how I felt and how I looked back end of 2019 prep. And this is probably why I've been feeling not great. I know I can be a lot leaner. Like, I know I can. It's not like I haven't been to that point before. So yeah, the plan is get leaner. Quite simply. I now have 2 cardio sessions on a rest day, whereas before I was just doing faster cardio in the morning. So I'm now doing 40 minutes fasted on a rest day and then 40 minutes in the afternoon between meals 4 and 5. So for me, that sits at about 5 p.m. And then on training days, what I'm doing is my normal 40 minutes on the Stairmaster first thing in the morning and then 25 minutes cardio post-workout. And the plan is to just keep pushing. We have time, and realistically it's just a matter of ticking the boxes now. I obviously am disheartened from the weekend, obviously, but what's the most important thing to do is not sit in this negativity for too long, because it will just start impacting my days, which is what I don't want to happen. So basically, Louis told me to get over it, get on with it, which was exactly what I needed here. Vicky told me she has my back. We've got time, you know. For me, I do need that reassurance. I don't have a lot of confidence in myself. I love this sport, but sometimes I really do doubt myself, and I know that's massively to my detriment. But having people tell me that I've got time and that I need to get over the weekend and just move on, that's been really helpful. I don't like being bullshit. I can always see straight through it as well. So I'm really grateful for Louis and Vicky for both kind of being realistic with me. Just looking forward to cracking on, to be honest. Well, I'm actually gonna clean my bikini today because I'll be wearing it again pretty soon. So it's really, really simple, and it's not risky. You're not gonna break your bikini. All that you need to do is run a washing up bowl of lukewarm water, and then just literally allow your bikini to soak in it. I find that actually just leaving it to soak, a lot of the tan and the dirt kind of comes out straight away. If you do find any like stubborn tan marks, then you can literally just use like a washing up cloth. Don't scrub crazy hard, obviously, but you know, the inside of the bikini doesn't have like crystals on, it's only the outside. So just kind of press out any of the tan stains, and then I always put my bikini on a hook, and yeah, just put it back to kind of drip dry. Don't like dry it with heat or anything like that. Just really helps everything look shiny, lift any kind of stains that you've got in there from tanning and that kind of thing. But yeah, just gonna show you what I'm doing. The amount of tan that was in that bucket of water is crazy. If your bikini is a darker colour, like mine's obviously like a darker purple, it's not always super obvious that there is tan on there. So make sure that you do soak it, and it will just make it brighter, make it pop more on stage. And for those of you that are worried about like
washing off the crystals. Not a single crystal came off. Like, you can tell when the crystals do come off because obviously it leaves like a mark where there's just glue and like a hole in the crystals. So yeah, I can't recommend Black Ice Bikinis enough. This is the second bikini I've had from them, and you know, the quality is unmatched. I'm actually going to end this video here. I will be putting together another video kind of bridging the gap between my second and third show and going into finals, but I just wanted to kind of hold myself accountable and say I placed fourth at the finals in 2019. My goal is to come in and beat that fourth place at the finals. I'd be lying if I didn't say I wanted to win. Of course I want to win. I don't do this sport to just kind of turn up and come away with a second, third, fourth like I did in 2019. I've worked fucking hard since then, and I'm not owed that first place. But I will do, and I will continue to do everything I can to win that British title. And I don't care if I end up looking stupid because I don't win it. I want that pressure on myself because this means a hell of a lot to me. And if I can bring a British champion look, then I will absolutely do that. So thank you ever so much for watching again. Do not forget to like this video and drop any comments, drop any questions that you have for me. And of course, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next video.